Hey, Mint Fox here with a quick how-to on switching from your physical SIM card to a new eSIM. Whether you've recently upgraded to an eSIM-only phone or just want to make the switch so you can brag to your friends, it is pretty cool. We can have you on an eSIM in no time. Well, a little time. First, we'll make sure you're using an updated version of the Mint mobile app. Then, we'll make sure you're using an eSIM-compatible phone. Then we'll install your eSIM and make sure it's working as intended. It's just that easy. Anyway, let's get started. Before you begin, you'll want to make sure you're connected to Wi-Fi and that you have the most recent version of the Mint mobile app installed on your device. Double-check in the App Store or Google Play to see if an update is in order. Once we're good there, open the app and log into your account. From here, you'll tap on Account, right here, and then select Order Replacement SIM, right here. When this screen pops up, select Get an eSIM as your option. If you don't see Get an eSIM as an option here, your phone may not support eSIM, so you'll have to stick with your physical SIM card. After selecting eSIM, the app will ask you to confirm that the phone you're using is the phone you want to install your eSIM on. So make sure that's the case, then select This is my new device to keep going. Tap Checkout to complete the order, and once that's done, you'll be prompted to install your eSIM. Follow these steps carefully, and be sure not to look directly at the screen as the eSIM activates. You've seen Raiders of the Lost Ark, right? Just kidding. You'll see the app processing for a moment and then a confirmation that the eSIM has been installed. After all that's over with, you can leave your physical SIM card in your phone if you'd like. Maybe it has sentimental value? Otherwise, feel free to take it out and toss it. Just don't use the empty SIM card slot for anything other than a physical SIM card. I know it might seem like a convenient place to put ketchup for dipping, but that would be very bad for the phone. You can, however, still use it for a second phone line if you'd like. And just like that, you're in the future. Well, just a couple of minutes into the future from when you started this video, which is now the present. Anyway, that's how you switch to an eSIM in just a few minutes. Take care!